What's up, YouTube? It's your boy DR2727. Shout out to my Transformers collectors, 1/6 scale collectors, whatever you collect, shout out to you. And first and foremost, I hope everybody's staying safe and taking care of yourself. I know this pandemic may be, you know, emotionally hard for some, physically hard for others. I pray that everybody's taking care of themselves, staying safe, and do what they need to do to, you know, be okay through all this. This month's video, first forgive me, because this was supposed to be a May 2020 video, and I'm sorry for doing it so late, because my initial video was going to be Transformers Toe to Toe, and it was going to be something different. It was going to be Legendary Displays versus Maju Cases. I tried to upgrade my display, and the reason I didn't do that was because Legendary Displays was a Kickstarter that didn't get funded, but they created a website, so I'm trying to wait to see the first group of people who get their products, like whether they are, they, you know, the quality they talked about during the Kickstarter and stuff like that. So if that happens, I will repost that video. But this video here is kind of to supplement that video. And it's a simple question. It's called acceptable losses. And what I mean by that is that as we evolve as a community and toys come out, there are things that, you know, as we become more mature in our collecting and more evolved in our collecting, there are things that, you know, and this is an individual question. What is acceptable to you and what is unacceptable to you? Like, what trade-offs are you willing to make in collecting? And so what got me on that was Iceman. Fans towards Iceman, as everybody knows, he doesn't really have a waist swivel. You have to undo the backpack to do the waist swivel, which, you know, everybody consider that not a waist swivel. And I'm in agreement with that, too. And waist swivels are, for me, basic points of articulation for masterpiece figures. Like, a waist swivel is a non-negotiable. It must have a waist swivel. And it got me thinking, just in general, what other things that I'm cool or not cool with. And I just have a couple of toys that are on display here and just some things that are trade-offs that, you know, maybe I'm cool with, maybe I'm not cool with. Things I have to ask myself. But, like, I put Warpath on here, Fans Toy Sheridan. And, you know, the trade-off with him is very minor. He didn't come with any accessories. But the major one was kind of the quality. I didn't have any problem with his quality. But, you know, I wasn't a trade-off not having any real accessories with it. For him, I was. Kang Toys, Ferocious, he's out of scale by a lot for the combined mode. Am I willing to accept that? I don't know, because I keep him. I think I can't answer that question until I get to combined mode. But, like, right now, he's horribly out of scale. And so, as of right now, that's a trade-off I can't really accept. But I'm playing the long game and hoping it works out. And kind of, I also have KFC Snapdragon back there because I just think that he's probably the worst masterpiece toy in my collection. He has no paint, you know, very little really masterpiece engineering. If you look and see, he has that huge backpack that wasn't in the cartoon, at least with the aerial bots. That was part of the characteristic in the cartoon. And so I think the more and more I see him, the less and less I'm okay with kind of things they didn't do with him. And so, like, they should have painted him and they should have hid that backpack. It shouldn't just be some huge thing hanging off his back or whatever. So as I ask this question to myself, I'm asking you guys also, what are acceptable losses or trade-offs that you guys are willing to tolerate for MP toys? And has it changed as toys have gotten better for you? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Again, thank you for watching. Stay safe.